These are Ukrainian Marines from the 36th Brigade. 5 years ago, they were betrayed by their own commander. He abandoned his post, as well as a number of other troops, and joined the Russian forces in 2014 during Moscow's annexation of Crimea. The story of their brigade is part of the Ukrainian resistance in the Black Sea Peninsula. They plan to present all the facts in a new documentary.
The thing is that we fought not only against the Russian occupiers, but inside the military unit as well. So all these facts are going to be presented in the film.
In the spring of 2014, Viktor Hrom, who was filming the events in the Crimean village of Perevalne, concealed the footage from his commanders, who switched over to the Russian side. Viktor then secretly transported the video to mainland Ukraine.
I made one copy and hid it in a Kyiv Patriarchate church. Another copy I managed to take out of Crimea.
Parishioners of the Ukrainian Orthodox Church supported the serviceman who resisted the invaders.
We will sanctify these demonic forces so that they couldn't never fire their automatic guns.
Russia's annexation of Crimea revealed where the loyalties of many servicemen lay.
It took many years for them to prepare before Russia could occupy Crimea. There was a large infiltration of Russian intelligence services.
Crimean Tatars, whom Russian propaganda was portraying as radical militants for many years, were one of the first to help the Marines.
Crimean Tatars, residents of Crimea, just ordinary people. They were the first volunteers. We didn't know how local residents could help. It was a pleasant surprise. Those people brought humanitarian aid, radio stations, bulletproof vests, generators, sacks. We got all this from them, because we were in isolation.
Isolation, betrayal, provocations, and constant pressure from occupiers. This is the atmosphere in which the 36th Brigade lived during the annexation of Crimea.
This was a much scarier situation than the one when you can see the enemy. Because when you can't see the enemy, you don't know what might happen tomorrow, what the situation on the border will be like.
When the rhetoric of the commander and his associates started changing in favor of the occupiers, Yuri Holovashenko took over leadership among those who stayed loyal to Ukraine. He was ready to counter Russian aggression.
At that moment we could fight, it could have been our last battle, but a really important one. It was pleasant to see my former subordinates, two company commanders, two of their deputies. There are the people who supported me during those times. To be honest, if it wasn't for them, I don't know how I would have survived. I could have been more aggressive or, the contrary, start looking for ways out.
Now the servicemen featured in the documentary continue fighting for Ukraine's freedom. They believe that one day they will be able to return to Crimea under the control of the Ukrainian government. Reported by Igor Medelyan, UATV.